Hi guys, so again today is Sunday, April 5th, and continue to cook dinner now. And this is the last recipe for this week, the chettinad style chicken curry. And so here they give you chicken, obviously. And then I am quite excited. I don't know if they made a mistake, but they gave like 2 packs of spinach. The 2 packs of spinach and the cilantro and the rice here. And then so in this recipe, they give you 2 spices. The one is just for the rice and the other one is for the rest of the dish. And so the garlic and the ginger paste. So I'm gonna get this recipe going here, you guys. And so I am so excited for this recipe. Oh my gosh, you guys, take a look at this. The portions are amazing. The spinach, it looks delicious. Oh my gosh. The yellow rice, it turned out perfect. And so there it is, guys, the chettinad style chicken curry. How does that look, you guys? And I do not know what the heck it is, but the spinach, I am gonna be making this spinach again. This spinach is so good. And yeah. All right, you guys. Yum, yum. It's early dinner call time today. It is Sunday dinner. It is April 5th, and it's just before 7 o'clock. And this is the last recipe for this week for Sunday dinner. And so it is the chettinad style chicken curry. And so this recipe will finish the 12 weeks of cooking that I've done of these recipe things. And so, oh my gosh, guys, 12 weeks. Ugh. Let's dig in because I'm hungry, you guys. Spinach. So let me just talk about this recipe, though. It kind of drives me crazy in a few different places here. Like whoever that writes these recipes, I think is sometimes a little bit crazy. And so they divided this recipe only in the 4 steps. And then so I look at the recipe back and forth and everywhere, and they give you cilantro. And then I'm like, what the heck do you do with the cilantro? And then you just use it at the very end. And then the one thing that drives me crazy is that they use the stems and the leaves together of the cilantro, and I don't like that. And so the last few recipes that called for cilantro, I actually took off the leaves and I just discarded the stems. And so that's what I've been doing. And also, the chicken, after they tell you to make the rice, they automatically dive into the chicken, but then they do not tell you to marinate the chicken. It's like, that drives me crazy. They tell you to put the spice on the chicken, but then they do not tell you to marinate it. It's like, what the heck? So before I started the rice, I put the marinade on the chicken and I marinated for a bit. And so that is what I did. So this recipe, they give you 2 spice packets. 1 spice for the chicken and 1 spice for the rice. I don't think they've ever done that before. yummy spinach. They cook the spinach with the coconut milk and some water. I learned a new way to cook spinach now, you guys. The beautiful yellow rice is just so cheerful color for these gloomy times. So apparently this is inspired by the Tamil culture in the Indian region of Chettinad. So yeah. So online it's so funny, like on their Facebook page with these guys. Some people are complaining about there's too many Indian choices or Asian flavors and stuff like that. I'm like, what the heck? Like, I love Indian flavors. It's like, bring me the curry every day. I can have curry every single day, you guys. I can have curry in a hurry. Which is, I have to remind myself because I want to make the recipe again. Because tomorrow, I got an early shift tomorrow. And so I have a 1 day gap to wait for my delivery on Tuesday. Where is it? Come on. I'm looking for it. Looking for ya. Talking about having curry every day. I am gonna be making this one again. I really want to make this one. Let's put this somewhere. This is a curried sheet pan bake. So I've got a similar spice blend to use at home with the Indian style spice, so I could use that. So I want to do that for dinner tomorrow. Talking about I can have curry every day. And so for Sunday dinner tonight, I was originally wanting to be lazy and I was originally wanting to order delivery. But then it's like I am telling myself to calm down, smack, smack. Like, who knows how long this coronavirus situation would be going on, and there will be many opportunities for getting delivery in the future, I'm sure. So I decided to calm myself down and just start cooking. Just calm down. I am just so amazed with myself, like the 12 weeks, like From before the 12 weeks, I always cook the single people lazy food. I got lazy and I just cooked the dumplings, dumplings, dumplings. And then who knew in 12 weeks I am just transformed and I'm just cooking up these recipes. And then I am eating fresher food, of course. I think for me, it is like an amazing transformation from cooking the one style to the other next style. And who knew 12 weeks ago, who knew there'll be a coronavirus situation happening? And who knew that this would be a form of entertainment, like cooking and stuff like that, and it gives me something to do. Yeah, I'm gonna be doing a recipe tomorrow. So this week there is only the one recipe that is not very good, which is the pasta recipe. It was so-so. Because I think the problem with this week is everything else, the flavors of the dishes are so elevated, and the pasta just seems pretty boring compared to all the other dishes that I've done. So that is probably why the pasta seems a bit boring this week. I am very excited to be able to have some steak this week. The steak was delicious. I made the chicken nice and crispy too. So today I saw the Queen's message. The Queen made a special broadcast about the coronavirus situation, and it's like I just love the way the Queen talks. Like I just love her speeches that she makes. I really say long live the Queen, like seriously. I rather listen to the Queen talk than listening to the Trudeau or Trump talk, either one of them. Because I think this is a special one because she only just does a broadcast on Christmas Eve, right? She just does her Christmas speech and she never makes any other speech like that. She basically told people to stay the F home, but she said it in a very courteous and nice way. So wonderful speech done by the Queen. Cheers. And talking about the Queen, after dinner tonight, I might just want to watch more Downton Abbey. So I'm so far in 12 weeks that I've done this recipe things, only just one recipe has gone bad on me. So that's a pretty good track record, I think. I don't know, some people, they seem to be making hater comments online or something. They say that they always receive the bad ingredients or something. But in my opinion, though, if you ever decide to subscribe to these meal subscription things, you do have to finish it within the week because they are fresh food, and so it might go bad if you keep on changing your plans or your dinner plans or whatever. And I understand for a lot of people, the life happens, the schedule changes, or whatever. Like, for example, for this week, I've got the shrimp, and so I know shrimp would go bad easier, so that is why I did the shrimp first. This rice is very flavorful. I think maybe a little bit much flavorful. So there we go, you guys. So this is the last recipe of the 12 weeks of cooking so far. And so it's been an amazing journey of 12 weeks of cooking. So hope you guys enjoyed hanging out with me for 12 weeks of cooking. And so yeah, so hopefully there's many more weeks to go. And yeah, so thank you so much for tuning in today, guys. And don't forget to check out all my other older videos on my playlist on my channel. And I will see you in the next one.